Okay, so here's my auto harvesting cactus farm and reed farm. The cactus farm is relatively simple. It has a little redstone underlay under here with pressure plates, and when it comes down here, this pops up. Just watch. Okay, there's nothing to detect. Yep. Goes down there. Now, please take note here, you need to add a block where you see the glowstone in this video. If you don't put a block there, the cactus will carry on growing up and it won't auto harvest itself, and it just won't drop down for you to collect. So do it that way, and if anything ever appears, oh, up it popped. That's just my bin. Here's the main attraction I'm going to be showing you in this video. It's a compact version of the version I'm going to show you. It's an auto harvester. All I have to do is just press the lever, and this water will shut off, and boom! Hello! Nom 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 nom. Then when you're done with that, turn it off. Replant it all, and you're all good. So, I'm going to show you the big auto harvester now. Okay, with the latest 1.7 update, we have received pistons. So, I've gone and touched up the well-known auto-harvesting sugarcane farm. Ooh, hello piggy. So, I've given it a touch-up with all the pistons, and it's now an auto-harvesting farm. All it requires is about 10 pistons, normal pistons, and bunch of water and a bit of redstone. It's simple enough. Just push the lever when you're done. The water here will stop, and the water all the way over there will ride and push it all towards you. Depending on how big you make it, you could carry this on completely all the way over there. It doesn't matter how far you make it, you can make it carry on going up, up, up and away, literally. So it's completely up to you. The redstone is actually really simple. It's just a lever going all the way up to the main redstone area. A couple of repeaters to make the middle water here come a few seconds after you shut off that water to give it chance to actually, for the water to go away and for this water to destroy the water coming along. So what the redstone is basically is you've got two pistons. All the pistons are facing the roof, so say it goes like this, and then you simply grab the piston and be sure you're under it and put them all like that. As long as they're all like that, this will work perfectly. The redstone for the middle gates go on the top, whereas the ones for the water feeding the sugarcane or reeds go along the bottom. They're all fed along the bottom here, and it all joins up here. So it's all powered by the same lever. All you have to do is just power the lever and it will shut it on or shut it off. I had to make a repair because I made it a little bit too long, but it works. Now you just turn it off. The main flip gate gets closed, so the pistons close that up and the pistons open up to let the water feed come. So all I have to do is just collect it. I haven't got enough space. Yeah, you just make a whole lot of sugarcane. So this is my design. It's basically part of many designs you've seen before on the internet, but I've just upgraded it with pistons. So if you guys want this design, all you have to do is keep watching this video. You'll see how it's all wired up and everything. The pistons are there. It's really easily laid out. There's no way you can get all this wrong. Water source block there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Along here, and then goes down one. I know water goes 8, but you've got to take into account of everything that happens. So you've got to take in the piston, and you've got to take in the end block. So basically, I just have it about this long. So yeah, I hope this has been educational, perhaps. And if you've got any questions, please leave them in the comment box. And I'll see you guys later.